the Ukrainian player, Yana Gapanova, to serve. Straight away there she is, dropping away from the table. And as we thought, Muzi staying close to the table. Strong forehand topspin on the diagonal. And it's first point to China. Umpire just asking Gapanova to throw the ball up a little bit higher. A well-placed rocket forehand topspin into the body of Gapanova.
Textbook tactics, I would say. Slow opening and then quick attack to the middle, or hard attack from the very beginning to the middle is also effective.
That was a remarkable shot from Gapanova, almost a chop block from close to the table. But whatever it was a winner, 2-1.
Also feeling out the forehand defensive side of Gapanova, which is normally the more difficult stroke, where you get out of your comfort zone a little bit on your forehand technique. You see, that is the shot that might be more difficult.
Just caught the top edge of Muzi's bat, flew off the end of the table. Gapanova constantly turning the bat round in her hand. Technique known as twiddling, playing with two different surfaces. You see there, the red side is the pimple side, and then the black side, the reverse rubber, the smooth surface. Both players can towel down every 6 points. Gapanova just taking the opportunity to compose herself. A relatively unforced error there by Gapanova. Fairly straightforward forehand push into the net. Heavy backspin from Gapanova there. Even though the ball was high, she managed to cut underneath it with the reverse side of the racket. Again, the umpire asking her to throw the ball up. Indeed, he's faulted her, having warned her once. He's taken the point. 5 points each at the halfway stage of the first game. Muzi, Michael, having a few problems against a heavy backspin.
She's not picking up that rate of the speed or the spin, I should say, very well. I mean, missed a few, one on net out and one right into the net. Better that time, but you're right, she seems to be hesitating a little bit on the heavy backspin, as you say, from Gapanova.
Again, a well-placed topspin into the body of Gapanova from Muzi. She didn't have problems reading the spin. It's just the excessive backspin generated by Gapanova that's causing Muzi the problem. Again, the umpire foul serving her for not throwing the ball. That's 2 points. Gapanova shakes her head. I think the problem for the players, Michael, when they get foul served is if it's a service they've done the previous five games and it's not being called, then suddenly it's called. I think that's the problem that the players have.
Standard is to set the standard the same for all umpires is, of course, a huge challenge in a tournament like this. No doubt about that. And they have to be prepared, actually, I think on the center court and on playing in the first venue and so on, maybe the courts are a little bit different, a little bit stricter. Done well in that rally though. I mean, kept her technique flowing quite nicely.
Consistent top spins from Muzi, and she takes the first game 11-7 and leads by 1-0.
Controlled the last rally well, actually, and never got too anxious to kill the ball, and that's of course the thing, patience, and you start to read the spin all the time on the defensive chops and put impart the right power in the ball.
It's interesting. I think when Gapanova really does impart excessive backspin, occasionally she's forced Muzi to push the ball, but then she's not been able to attack that shot. A world-class defensive player for me has to be able to defend as well as Gapanova does. There's no question of her defensive ability, but they have to be able to turn defense into attack very quickly, and we haven't seen that yet from Gapanova. Hopefully from her point we will see it.
And don't forget also a couple of false serves, actually two right off the so still 11-6. I thought she got into it quite well, actually. She's playing I believe on her level, ranked 95 in the world. Quite experienced, I guess, 31 years of age.
And there we saw an attacking shot from Gapanova. That's exactly what she has to do. There's no doubt Muzi is not completely comfortable against the backspin. Not a lot of spin on the ball. Muzi lifts. There's not the spin there to lift. So the ball goes off the end of the table. Good start by Garna Gapanova of the Ukraine. Ball mid-table, a little bit too high. You see there, it's popped up. And good deception from Muzi. Gapanova wasn't sure which direction the ball was going. She knew exactly where that one was going. She waited, blocked it down the line.
Done that two times now, actually. Just stretching out her backhand and going down the line very quickly. Nice shots.
That wasn't a million miles away either. Very close. Held her ground. Looked to block it down the line. It's a good start by the Ukrainian player. Just see how close that is, millimeters away from the white line. Two serves to come now for Gapanova. Forehand topspin out wide. Gapanova's forehand, a couple into the body, and then the switch out wide. There's the one into the body. This one goes wide to the forehand with a little bit of side spin to take it even wider.
Following your tactics, Mr. Parker, she's trying to attack now in the second game, but I like it also, the fact that she's sometimes staying, as we said, closer to the table, you know, blocking a backhand down the line and sort of changing up her game a bit.
that well-placed topspin from Muzi. Capanova wasn't sure whether to play with the backhand or with the forehand, and she ended up playing a compromise shot, and timeout has been called by the Ukrainian coach. Each player has one timeout in the match. It's a 1 minute breaking play, often used by the coaches when they feel the opponent has got the momentum. And quite clearly there, Muzi has pulled away back into this second game and indeed now has a lead. And so the Ukrainian coach will be hoping that a 1 minute break, words of wisdom from himself.
It's interesting by seeing the shift, as you say, of sides. You don't see that so frequently actually anymore, but she sort of had that in her defensive rhythm. She just switches, but sometimes back to the same side.
Heavy backspin from Capanova, came underneath the ball, fast accelerating wrist with an open racket, sends the ball back fizzing with backspin. So, two consecutive points after the timeout. It's just what the Ukrainian coach wanted. Interesting with Muzi, we discussed her current ranking at 833. She won the Swedish Open back in 2015, made the semi-final of the World Championships back in 2015. Then we haven't seen a great deal of her, so fascinating to see her here. Quite clearly one to watch as this tournament progresses, but she's got a fight on her hands here. She's won the first game 11-7. She's being made to fight for every point, six each in this second game. It probably was the wrong shot to play. It was down the forehand. We'll see here. She comes across and tries to play a backhand from way over on the forehand side. Didn't have the control. 7-6. Muzi, China leads. Has to keep the ball deep on Muzi's side of the table. Get everything on the baseline if you possibly can. Anything mid-table, Muzi will make you pay.
You made a good point there. I think it's just about the depth or how long you can, especially in the balls in the beginning, in the start of the chops, that they have to be of good quality. Otherwise, it's almost impossible to control or to play the ball deep if you're getting hard attacks. You know, ball will rise and much harder to get it deep on the other side of the table.
Here we see spraying the ball around the table. Smash, top spins coming up the back of the ball, then the ball's a little bit too high from Capanova, and Muzi smashes straight through the back of the ball, which you can do when the ball's that little bit higher. Shot. She really is using her wrist with the reverse side of the racket on the forehand side. She just have a look at that again. Here she comes, the black side, side spin and back spin on the ball.
Real aggressive chopping style. As you said, very much open racket. So she brushes under the ball and it's burning with spin.
Pivotal moment here, 9-all, second game. Can Gapanova get back in this match? Again, mid-table, slightly high. Muzi pounced on the opportunity and now has, as you can see on the screen, a game point. Oh, unlucky, the tactics were right by Gapanova. She needs to take on the attacking shot, but she mistimed that one and she loses the second game 11-9, and it's Muzi who leads by 2-0.
Did well in this game though, absolutely played our strongest game so far, and had it 9-all service on her own, so you can really not expect anything more from Ganna Gapanova so far. She's giving it all her she got.
When you look at her results over the last 4 or 5 years, she's made the last 32 of a lot of the big tournaments, including the World Championships 2 years ago in China, but rarely progresses beyond that stage. So clearly she's one of the top players, but just needs to move up a notch, and this is a great opportunity for her. Although now at 2-0 down, it's going to be tough. You see there, the statistic that stands out to me there is Gapanova made 6 winners. To show she was prepared to attack, which is exactly what we spoke about in between the first and second game. Inevitably you'll make some errors, but she actually made more winners than she did unforced errors, as you can see on the screen. So here we go, it's the third game and it's Gapanova to serve.
Backhand service again, kind of a strange, very consistent umpiring, of course, but he apparently didn't like her backhand service.
Heartbreaking. It's a difficult one. I don't want to sound as though I'm not in favour of the umpires. If a player foul serves, then of course the umpire should call the foul serve. As I said earlier, that the players want consistency, they want a level playing field, they don't want anybody having an unfair advantage. And it's a tough job for the umpires. But my sympathy with the players is when they've done a service in a previous round and it's been okay, they do the same service in the next round and they get called. That's, and you said, Michael, when we mentioned this before, it's tough with so many players here, so many umpires, and they do a great job, there's no question about that.
I couldn't agree more, but she almost by automatic took that backhand serve again, and she served only 4-run for the second game, for example, and then sort of came back and then, oh, forgot about that. And it can be hard to change the service technique also in a sort of a pressure point. If you used to have a certain length of your throw and just throw it a little higher, it can be sort of put you off the rails a bit with your serve, and you know also, of course, that your service quality has to be extremely good against a player like Muzi.
But Muzi now seems to be reading the spin. She seems to be dealing with the heavy backspin a lot better than she did in the first and second game. And then when you add the point and the psychological blow of being foul served again, this game looks very much one-way traffic. 7-1. Muzi racing towards a 3-0 lead. just a heavy backspin. Open racket, fast accelerating wrist going underneath the ball. Oh, that's a good backhand hit down the line. Held her ground, punched it down the line. And the crowd beginning to grow, but of course, this is the first round of the competition. When we get to the last 16 and beyond, then it's a complete sellout here in Dusseldorf. 8,000 seats. All 8,000 seats have been sold. What an atmosphere it will be. And Musi content just to topspin into the forehand of Gapanova. 8-3. No spin on the push from Gapanova. Musi thought there was a little bit of backspin, so she lifts the ball, but of course there's no backspin there to lift. So Gapanova trying to claw her way back into this third game, but she was well down. She's pulled it back a little bit.
Makes some error where she's kind of rushing that and taking a high level of risk, and it's quite a bit of a swing there. She's also a little off balance in her technique, I would say. So a few things working together to kind of put her in a not so good position to hit the table. That was better. More spin on her forehand attack, more patience.
Edge of the racket flies off the end of the table. Strong finish from Gapanova. Probably too far behind at this business end of the third game, but let's wait and see. 2 points here would be very useful. There's one of them, and she's now got her two serves to come.
Don't take the backhand service. That would be my spontaneous coaching.
Interesting. Timeout called by the Chinese coach Li Gusheng. So certainly a very animated conversation there in the Ukrainian corner, but they should be pleased. She's played well. She played very well in the second game, 11-9. She's clawed her way back into this third game. Slightly more reserved in the Chinese corner. Nine-seven, of course. Musi in the lead, but just a few errors creeping in. Some good attacking shots, which we haven't seen at the start of this match from Gapanova. So, Chinese coach clearly felt the momentum with Gapanova. Let's see how both players react to a 1 minute break in play. Two serves now for Gapanova. Oh, that's a well placed forehand topspin again. That area of indecision. Gapanova wasn't sure whether to play forehand or backhand, and so it's three game points for China. And there it is. A good tactical timeout called by the Chinese coach, Li Gusheng. And the third game is won by Musi, 11 points to 7. and that's a 3-0 lead. So whilst we've seen some improved play, with the, particularly on the attacking side from Gapanova, it's going to be a mountain to climb. She's clearly having a word with the umpire there about the service call, and clearly very frustrated about it. I'm not sure if your Ukrainian's better than mine, Michael, but they certainly seem to have a lot to say to each other.
But as you said, then hopefully there are some positive words of wisdom here too, right?
It is interesting though, isn't it? You've coached many top players. I coached the England team for a while, and some players come off, don't say a word, they just listen, and some players, you can't shut them up. They're very vocal, they're very much, they want to talk, they want to get things off their chest. It varies very much from player to player.
She's certainly showing some fire, and I think she's fought well here. I mean, she's really a fighter, staying in into the match, focusing all the time, and going for the win. And what a lovely kind of approach to this match.
The one thing I think she hasn't got in her repertoire in the cupboard is a strong forehand topspin. She's blocked well on the backhand, but if a soft ball comes to a forehand, I've not seen her really come in with a strong forehand topspin. And when I think of the world-class defenders, both male and female, you know, somebody does a bad serve that goes slightly long or a weak return, they're in with a strong forehand topspin. Doesn't seem to have that particular shot, but she's certainly got everything else and a tremendous fighting spirit to go with it.
You wonder also how much it means that she has to be forced now to take what I believe is her second option for service positioning, basically using her forehand serve. And sometimes maybe it's part of her DNA as a player to serve back and attack after that. And there's a lot of things obviously that plays into the picture. And of course, Musi finding her groove and game and playing, especially with their serve now, a little different. So I'm sure a little longer and more variation of service is something that is benefiting her. And Musi, of course, a player to be really accounted for here, comes in lower ranking, which can stir up the seeding. Of course, she should be, if not the top seed, at least top 8 seed, maybe perhaps in a tournament like this, and coming in as unseeded and then sort of climbing your way through the draw, upsetting the order and so on. So not a play to take lightly at all in championships like this.
It's all over now for Gorna Gapanova, barring a miracle.
And you've been a coach, I've been a coach. Maybe the coach is in for a hard time now. So after that discussion coming out and then losing, that can be sort of a tough day for the coach. Who knows?
We might have a diplomatic point at this point in time. I think that's fair to say that was a diplomatic point.
Yeah, well, no more diplomacy now. Never mind.
So there it is. Outstanding performance, particularly in the fourth game by Musi, but a gutsy performance by Gorna Gapanova. Albeit the fourth game all slipped away. She had some tough decisions from the umpire, but a really good performance by Musi. And as you say, Michael, going forward, she's come through the qualification. She should really be probably seeded in the top eight. So she's going to cause some damage somewhere in the draw. Not a player you'd want early in this tournament. She's really into the swing of things now. She's played 5-6 games, and she's going to be one tough opponent to beat. So it's Muzi of China through to the second round of the women's singles. Good consistent top spins from Muzi, and she takes the first game 11-7 and leads by 1-0.
Controlled the last rally well, actually, and never got too anxious to kill the ball, and that's of course the thing, patience, and you start to read the spin all the time on the defensive chops and put the impart the right power in the ball.
It's interesting. I think when Gapanova really does impart excessive backspin, occasionally she's forced Muzi to push the ball, but then she's not been able to attack that shot. A world-class defensive player for me has to be able to defend as well as Gapanova does. There's no question of her defensive ability, but they have to be able to turn defense into attack very quickly, and we haven't seen that yet from Gapanova. Hopefully from her point we will see it.
And don't forget also a couple of false serves actually too right off the so still 11-6. I thought she got into it quite well, actually. She's playing I believe on her level, ranked 95 in the world. Quite experienced, I guess, 31 years of age.
And there we saw an attacking shot from Gapanova. That's exactly what she has to do. There's no doubt Muzi is not completely comfortable against the backspin. Again, a well-placed topspin into the body of Gapanova from Muzi. She didn't have problems reading the spin. It's just the excessive backspin generated by Gapanova that's causing Muzi the problem. But again, the umpire foul serving her for not throwing the ball. That's 2 points. Gapanova shakes her head. I think the problem for the players, Michael, when they get foul served is if it's a service they've done the previous 5 games and it's not being called, then suddenly it's called. I think that's the problem that the players have.
Standard is to set the standard the same for all umpires is, of course, a huge challenge in a tournament like this. No doubt about that. And they have to be prepared, actually. I think on the center court and on playing in the first venue and so on, maybe the calls are a little bit different, a little bit stricter. Done well in that rally, though. I mean, kept her technique flowing quite nicely.
Ukrainian player, Dana Gapanova, to serve. straight away there she is, dropping away from the table. And as we thought, Muzi staying close to the table. Strong forehand topspin on the diagonal. And it's first point to China. Umpire just asking Capanova to throw the ball up a little bit higher. A well-placed rocket forehand topspin into the body of Capanova.
Textbook tactics, I would say. Slow opening and then quick attack to the middle, or hard attack from the very beginning to the middle is also effective.
That was a remarkable shot from Capanova, almost a chop block from close to the table. But whatever it was, it was a winner, 2-1.
Also feeling out the forehand defensive side of Capanova, which is normally the more difficult stroke, where you get out of your comfort zone a little bit on your forehand technique. You see, that is the shot that might be more difficult.
Just caught the top edge of Muzi's bat, flew off the end of the table. Capanova constantly turning the bat round in her hand. Technique known as twiddling, playing with two different surfaces. You see there, the red side is the pimple side, and then the black side, the reverse rubber, the smooth surface. Both players can towel down every 6 points. Capanova just taking the opportunity to compose herself. A relatively unforced error there by Capanova. Fairly straight forward forehand push into the net. Heavy backspin from Capanova there. Even though the ball was high, she managed to cut underneath it with the reverse side of the racket. Again, the umpire asking her to throw the ball up. Indeed, he's faulted her, having warned her once. He's taken the point. 5 points each at the halfway stage of the first game. Certainly, Muzi, Michael, having a few problems against the heavy backspin.
She's not picking up that rate of the speed or the spin, I should say, very well. I mean, missed a few, one on net out and one right into the net. But at that time, but you're right, she seems to be hesitating a little bit on the heavy backspin, as you say, from Capanova.
Not a lot of spin on the ball. Muzi lifts. There's not the spin there to lift. So the ball goes off the end of the table. Good start by Garna Capanova of the Ukraine. Ball mid-table, a little bit too high. You see there, it's popped up. And good deception from Muzi. Capanova wasn't sure which direction the ball was going. She knew exactly where that one was going. She waited, blocked it down the line.
Done that two times now, actually. Just stretching out her backhand and going down the line very quickly. Nice shots.
That wasn't a million miles away either. Very close. Held her ground. Looked to block it down the line. It's a good start by the Ukrainian player. Just see how close that is. Millimeters away from the white line. Two serves to come now for Capanova. Forehand topspin out wide. Capanova's forehand, a couple into the body, and then the switch out wide. There's the one into the body. This one goes wide to the forehand with a little bit of side spin to take it even wider.